Time now for our Ford feature. Simeon Rice, known for dominating the Big Ten as a pass rusher for the Illini, the Big Ten's all-time sack leader, then went to the NFL where he went to 3 Pro Bowls and won a Super Bowl with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And now he's on to the next stage of his life. Now he is director, producer of a new movie coming out in less than 2 weeks, and it's called Unsullied. And we have the pleasure of being joined by Simeon Rice right here. Congratulations.
Thanks for having me.
Good to see you.
It's good to see you too.
Did Simeon Rice become a director producer of a feature film?
If I was to go deep into that journey, it'd be too dark, too bleak. It's a whole nother movie.
Wow.
So to give you the short, I had a passion for it. After I finished playing, I kept myself and I held myself to the standards in which I played. I believe a man should be a man of his word. I said to myself, I want to be a filmmaker. And I went to film school.
And you went to film school in New York for it?
I went to film school in L.A. I went to film school, New York Film Academy in L.A. So that's where I cut my teeth.
How was the process? Tougher than you thought?
The process of making a film in school?
Yeah, the process of making a film.
The process of making a film is a ever-growing process of a lot of hurdles that you have to get around, but it's fun. It's enlightening. It's anticlimactic. It's movie magic. It's all those other euphemisms for, you know, what one would do in terms of chasing his dreams.
I read a little bit about the movie, and this is my type of movie. I'm all about a thriller. I'm all about an adventure movie. Mm-hmm. We have a trailer here, so we're going to show it to the audience. Okay. Let's roll with the trailer.
In the woods.
You boys, aren't you?
Yeah, you could say that.
And the road ends.
The forest, it ain't no place to lose your way.
Whose idea?
Go to Fandango and go buy it.
Man, I mean, whose idea was to put together a script like this?
I did. I wrote it, I directed it, did everything. It was a tough process.
But enjoyable.
Very, very enjoyable.
Challenging?
The film went to heights and epics that I could never imagine. That young lady, Mary Gray, took this film to epic levels. It's a thrill ride of a film. If you like film and you want to be at the edge of your seat, you go check out, go buy your tickets, Fandango.com. It's playing at the AMC. You know, we got the national, nationwide release. It's a joy. Support your
Chicago guy.
Yeah, for real, Chicago. And showing you basically the theme of it. Yeah, the theme is an action thriller suspense, dangerous game of kill or be killed. But moreover, this story is deeper than that. This story is about a kid from the south side of Chicago that really, really just wanted to make good on himself. And I think that's what this is all about, you know, really. That's what it's really all about.
Let me ask you a couple football questions.
Gotcha.
Have you been following the NFL?
Of course.
You played with Jay Cutler for a year.
I did.
Can you turn around?
I wouldn't say a year. I said I played for a little bit, and then I left that situation.
You guys were in Denver?
Yeah, we were teammates.
All right. You know him a little bit. You watch him. You still keep up with the league. Can a guy like John Fox turn around his career?
John Fox is a tremendous coach. He's a fun coach. Actually, he was in Denver when I was in Denver. So he's a fun coach to play for. They have a deep, rich history. If anybody's going to be able to pull something out of him, it's John.
What is it about Fox that players love? Why?
He's a player's coach. He's a player's coach, and he focuses on what's important, and that's playing. And he already has a familiarity with the quarterback. He has a strong familiarity with him. I played against him so many times in the South, in the NFC South, when he was in Carolina. He always had those teams ready to go. And guys rally behind guys like that. Guys rally around coaches that seems like they're having fun coaching them. You know, so guys like being coached up and having fun doing it.
You watched this team last year. You watched the Bears last year. It was pretty brutal. How long is it going to take for John Fox to turn this thing around?
I don't know. That's a good question. How long? You know, you can't really put a timetable on it. But I think immediately each game is going to get better. Guys are going to evolve and start really buying into it. It's really when they buy in to what he wants to his basically his overall model of this thing for the team.
You got two new coordinators, so that's kind of tough for the players. Another new system for Jay Cutler. You got these new coaches coming
in. These guys are pros, though.
Yeah, they adjust pretty quickly.
These guys are pros. They used to that. And if anybody, you know, this team in itself is used to that kind of like revolving door, because that's how it's been for a little bit here. But John is a guy that can rally these guys and get these guys to play for him. If anybody that could do it in a short time frame, it's John Fox.
You're a guy that could have played for Vic Fangio, too. An attacking defense.
I could play it for anybody.
It looks like you could still play.
I was
going
to say, you miss playing? Anybody.
Do I miss playing? I like making movies. Go check this film out.
We will check it out. It comes out August 28th,
like it or love it. Check me out. Send me out _Rice on Twitter. Let me know whether you like it, love it, hate it. It doesn't matter. Go see it.
I will let you know. Thanks for coming by.
No doubt.
Congratulations. Simeon Rice joining us here on The Final Word.